Hey folks, this is me, Jaspal Lelil, joining with you from Team Indian Folk, India's emerging opinion sharing platform. We at Indian Folk thrives as a young community where the youth of the country shares their opinions and reflects on the various events and matters that happens around us. The concept of universal basic income came into the Indian political arena after the former economic advisor Arvind Subramaniam spoke about this concept and its application in the Indian scenario. Universal basic income refers to that particular unconditional payment in cash or benefit transfers made to the people's account or in direct cash payment to support the poor people who do not have a regular income. It is largely a social policy than an economically efficient policy due to the fact that it is trying to bring the poor people of a country on par with the rich and affluent sections of the society. By providing a universal basic income, the nation can ensure that all the people in the country are getting a minimum standard of earnings in the form of cash benefits, and which these people can later use for the consumption and other expenditure purposes. This idea has been there since the early 1960s, but it's not widely practiced because of the fact that many countries fear the fiscal and monetary burden that such a policy can create on the shoulder of the economy. When you say that you transfer benefits without any conditions, you're essentially looking for the problem of free rider in an economy where people have this moral hazard to receive benefits without actually taking an effort for the same. It is also against the efficiency criterion in economics, which talks about the distribution of resources based on merit and not based on the social conditions. In a country like in India, where if you try to implement a policy like universal basic income, it can have a serious drain on the state exchequer. Considering the fact that more than 20 to 30% of the total population live in poverty, such a policy initiative will require a huge amount of money which otherwise could be spent in defense, education and healthcare. This also reduces the concept of meritocracy from the Indian scenario, which already has several provisions like reservation based on caste and cultural norms. Well, this doesn't mean that the concept of universal basic income shouldn't be implemented in our country, but rather there is no point in replicating the concept of universal basic income that we had in other countries. In the particular case of India, we have to take into consideration the larger population that exists in our country and also the larger number of poor people who reside within our society. While there must be some form of support system to enable these people to get out of the vicious cycle of poverty, it must be also remembered that this shouldn't come at the cost of rapid economic growth that our country is experiencing for the past several decades. While social policies can have an outreaching impact on the lives of the people, it can also have a serious negative impact on the economy of a country. After all, economy largely operates on the norms of efficiency than equality. As a result, there must be a policy like universal basic income which can help people, especially the poor people, to get out of the vicious cycle of poverty. However, its planning and implementation must be done with utmost care so that it won't drain the valuable resources that our country have. To read this article as well as several other wonderful articles on the latest happenings around you, please log on to indianfolk.com. You can also follow us and stay yourself updated by following us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube and Instagram. Thank you so much for watching this video.